Bags Club, Bags Club, welcome to Bags Club, Bags Club, Bags Club, welcome to Bags Club. My friend adores Fat Labrador, but his dog and I don't see eye to eye. His name's Dennis, he's a menace. He attacked me once on the way to play tennis. He went for my balls, they're precious to me. New balls, please. A walk in the park, things soon went dark. So he took off his lead, did another misdeed. In lightning speed, a lady's lunch he'd feed. With a rap on the floor, my friend says done this before. One stole fisherman's fish, he stole his dish. That's a naughty Dennis. when Dennis was little. We used to be mates. Then he tried to eat the glasses off my face. He wouldn't stop. I cried for help. Everybody laughed. I'm a pathetic yelp. I may be a geek, but he's a beast. Please let me live in peace. Oh yeah, let me do some funky bass lines. I should be the Jenny Bennett. A barbecue, Dennis. Behind up my steak. And then the drool come down his face. I offered him a Pringle, but it was too late. He was under the table and grabbed my plate. He once almost ate a tired chocolate cake. This dog's a nutcase. And now Dennis seated on therapy to rid his demons, the dog exorcist. I hope he finds some inner zen. No longer scream, no, stop it, Den. And becomes a good boy. It's like Lassie, so I have to flee the country.
Hello, everybody. Welcome again to Bags of Love podcast. This is June 2023. Hope you all keeping safe and doing well. So, the first three tracks that you heard, number one was The Loneliest Monk with Bone Weary. The Loneliest Monk is the brainchild of local musician Phil Musker from Ulverston. And yeah, big fan of what the music that he's producing, very like ambient instrumental music. Perfect for these summer days, and it's from his EP Tunes in A&D, which is available on Bandcamp. So if you liked that one, you know, check out his other stuff. It's really, really good, and he's helped out with Bags of Love albums previously. Second track was Grant Curnow with Dennis the Menace. Grant is a Manchester-based musician on our local Sea House Records label, and he's a fantastic songwriter. The song itself is about a dog. A friend of ours, and you know, if you listen to the song, it doesn't paint a nice picture of Dennis. But I had the lucky chance of meeting Dennis at the weekend up the lakes, and I must say, you know, you've got the wrong impression there, Grant, because he's a very nice dog. Actually, he was he was following me around and checking up on me quite a bit, and he was quite a friendly dog. You know, I'm not really a dog lover either, so yeah, Dennis. I think I'm going to write a song promoting Dennis actually in a good light. So that was Grant Curnow, Dennis the Menace. His stuff's on Spotify from his Salvador Dalek EP. Third track you heard was Native Cult with Peaches. Peaches actually appeared on one of our Bags of Love albums a couple of years ago. I think it was the third album. So I'm a big fan of that song. It's really summery vibes, so that's why I played that one. And yeah, they're still going. They're doing quite well. I think they played Highest Point Festival in Lancaster at the weekend. So yeah, good luck to them. So welcome to this month's podcast. And cheers for listening in. So this month we've got 10 tracks, three of which you've heard. We've got some fantastic local music. We'll be delving into some music from the past, and we've also got an interview with local legend, I must say that, Paul Day, who's a fan of the local music scene for a long time. So we're gonna have an interview with him, and he has selected three of his favorite tracks from the last few decades, which we'll be playing on the podcast. So I am really looking forward to that. So the next two tracks you'll be hearing are both cover versions from local singers. We've got Steve Forster with I've Got to Be Me. So Steve sent me this fantastic cover version, really strong vocals. Steve is a local singer, entertainer, he's absolutely super busy. If you know who he is, he just never stops, always traveling across Cumbria with his partner Louise. They've got a duo called Anyone, which I've seen quite a few.
Whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong, whether I find a place in this world or never belong, I've gotta be me. Yeah, I've gotta be me. What else could I be but what I am? I wanna live, not merely survive, and I won't give up this dream or life that keeps me alive. I've gotta be me. Oh, I've gotta be me. The dream that I see makes me what I am. That faraway prize, a world of success, is waiting for me. If I hear the call, I won't settle down, I won't settle for less. As long as there's a chance, I'll have it all. I'll go it alone, be. I can't be right for someone else if I'm not right for me. I've gotta be free. Yeah, I've gotta be free. Daring to try, do it or die. I've gotta be me. I'll go it alone. someone else found that right for me. I gotta be me.
When you were here before, couldn't look you in the eye. You're just like an angel. Your skin makes me cry. You've flown like a feather in a beautiful world. I wish I was special.
Last two songs that you heard with Steve Forster, I've Got To Be Me, and Becki Fishwick with Creep. So thank you to both of those artists for sending me those fantastic tracks. and give them a follow on social media if you want to find out more about those two. So we're going to have an interview now with Paul Day, who's a friend of mine, but he's also a big fan of like local music and the local music scene, so he selected three tracks. So hi Paul.
Hi Jonny, good afternoon.
How are you today?
I'm okay, thank you mate, I'm doing alright.
Keeping well?
I'm keeping well mate.
Sun's shining,
it's a beautiful day.
Spot on. Well, first of all, thank you for coming in and thank you for selecting three tracks for us.
No problem mate, no problem at all.
We're going to be talking about them in a bit. But first of all, just introduce yourself, explain a little bit about your experience with the local music scene.
Right, my name's Paul Day, and I'm not a musician as such. Well, even though, way back in 2006, I did do a little bit of singing.
I remember that.
Yeah,
I was in a duo with me mate Dan Muir, who were called Sunshine and Love.
Yes, I do remember, actually. I think.
And we wrote about five or six songs together.
So you're lying, you are a musician.
Well, it's a long time ago now, isn't it? So yeah, well, we did that for maybe about a year or so, and then he was just basically supporting a local band from 2007 called The Irie. If people have heard them from back in the day, they released three albums themselves. So I used to basically go on the road with them, and they didn't do many local gigs in Barrow at that point. When they first started, it was always out of town gigs.
Yeah.
So we used to get in a van, pack the van up and go down in cars and set it all up, and basically I'd go on first in a packed pub who didn't know and sing songs that are written, which really wasn't that good at the time, but looking back on it, I kind of cringe that I actually used to do that. But
fun times though.
Yeah, they were good days. They're really good days. And ever since then, I've just been involved in the local Barrow music scene, as they say, for over 20 odd years now.
Wow.
Which is something I'm very proud of. I've come across some fantastic bands over the years. And I've also met some really great friends from them times. So, and a lot of them, like yourself, Jonny, are still friends with me today.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's been really good.
Yeah, feeling old now, Paul. Thanks for that.
Yeah, well, I'm 40 next year, mate. So you know what I mean. It's all downhill, isn't it?
Oh, it's all good, mate. All good. It's memories. So next question, which I've got, is what are your favourite memories from being a fan of local music?
When I first started going on the local music scene, I was 18. And obviously it was before kind of social media really took off and stuff like that. So to find out about gigs, I used to read the Evening Mail, and there was another friend of ours called Gary Robinson wrote a local piece in the paper called The Going Out Guide.
Yeah, I do remember that, yeah.
Yeah, and you basically that's where you found wherever like gigs were happening and different venues. I mean, back then, like Thursday nights, kind of like Battle of the Bands, and even Thursday, Friday, Saturday nights, even Sundays, some occasions, there was loads of different venues and loads of local bands. So you could go anywhere and watch different bands if you wanted to each week, and it was just really, really good. But that's how we kind of found out about it. And I'm going to talk about these tracks that we've picked from the bands, but my old school friends formed a band, and they were called Acquiesce. It later became Cartel, which... Again.
I was a member of.
You were a member of. So from going to watch them, my schoolmates and stuff like that, I'd obviously go and support them and stuff like that. And then I'd meet bands like the Optimus Prime, Shite Heads, The Origin, and basically a load of other bands from that era. So, yeah, some really good times, some really good venues.
Yeah, I mean, just add to that, I know I've had the same conversation lately with quite a few people how, you know, without sounding cliche, the music scene has changed like really dramatically.
Massively, yeah.
Grassroots level, I mean.
Yeah.
You know, when I first started going out and gigging, you could go and watch a band of any description any night of the week in Barrow, and the pubs were always heaving. It was never a trouble to get people down there.
No.
The nightlife and kind of, don't know, society was a lot different, really. Like you said, it's pre-mobile phones, well, and more mobile phones just coming in, but like you said, that you know, the old format of music journalism in terms of you know, like I was a big reader of the NME and stuff like that.
I was. So just collect them
to find out before the internet, to find out what was going on, you literally had to go at word of mouth or through the newspaper.
Correct. Yeah.
Which you don't really getting out, so it's all
good days, good times then.
It's all Facebook and stuff, but yeah, that, you know, the old, and Pete Mossop took that on after Gary Robinson, didn't he? And I used to look forward to that really genuinely, you know, Thursday and you could send your CD and get a good review. You could get a review, or you could find out what's going on live wise. Yeah, there were good times, different times. You know, it's not always bad. Your social media can kind of has a lot of benefits. You know, in terms of getting out to more people, I suppose. But yeah, it is. It's just different, isn't it now?
Yeah, completely.
Good times. So moving on to the actual tracks. Okay.
Yeah.
I'll just read them out. We've got Optimus Prime, New Day, Shy Ted's with 100%, and The Origin There Is Love. So let's start with the first one, Optimus Prime, New Day. Why have you?
Optimus Prime, New Day was basically one of the... Again, it's probably one of the first bands I've ever seen live. I think I've seen them before I've seen the other two. And they'd released these seven... Well, they always used to play these songs live and stuff. And
yeah, we've got the CD here with us. We're looking at it right now. Yeah. And it's a great CD.
Yeah, it's a fantastic... Even the cover. The cover itself is just...
Iconic. Brilliant. Can you describe it for me?
It's just basically full of beer. Yeah, full of beer mats. Rizzlers. It was just basically what the band was about at that time. It was just basically a party cultured band, but they released some really great songs, and I really got into them. Yeah. And they used to do Battle of the Bands. I think it was like a Super Sunday, and that was used to be. We're going back a long time now, but this was over the Periscope.
Yeah, I used to go. Yeah, I'd play them.
Yeah, and obviously it'd be all kinds of different bands, and then Optimus Prime are pretty much normally headline it, and then they play these seven songs, and then they'd also play a lot of covers as well at the time. And yeah, it was just really, really, I really enjoyed going to, like, back in them, because like you say, we were talking about this earlier, it was like youth and energy, and it was just first getting into music, you're 18, and it's just...
You take on the world.
And taking on the world, you know what I mean? It was just really, it was really enjoyable.
You still can, Paul.
You still, yeah. I'm just getting old now. I've got to calm down a bit, slow down.
Yeah. So New Day, just add to that. I mean, I later played in Optimus Prime on bass. I didn't play on this CD. But yeah, I mean, I haven't heard these songs for years, a long time. So I really enjoyed. I picked these CDs off Paul, and you know, ripped them off my computer, and I spent a couple of hours really reminiscing and listening to them, and it brought back so many memories. Or half memories, but yeah, New Day, Optimus Prime. It's a really great track. Dead catchy. It's got it does have loads of energy, doesn't it?
It does. Yeah, raw energy.
And although it's not like the best recording as such, quality wise, it does still capture that energy that the band had with the drums. You know, Jevon Turner was on drums, Craig Chapman on vocals, Danny McGuire on guitars, and Matty Potter on bass. And it was recorded at South Lake Studio in Ulverston by the legend that is Colin Williams. I don't know what he's up to these days, but he used to record a lot of the bands. He was like the Matt Kassell of 20 years ago. So yeah, that's the first one. Thanks for telling me about that. Next song is after that is going to be Shy Ted's 100%. Tell me about that one.
Yeah, Shy Ted's the band that basically they didn't really do that. Well, I'd say they didn't do that many gigs, but I wasn't always available to go and watch them play. I only really caught them a few times. But I remember seeing them in the Duke, and obviously I kind of knew Jeff from Optimus Prime and stuff like that, so I knew he was in the band. I didn't know the other three, but I got to know him later on down the line, and Daryl Waite, the singer from the Shiteheads, he's still doing it now. He's in his current band in Insula.
Insula, yeah, he's still going, Daryl.
Still going, still rock and rolling. And he played this song 100%, and it was quite a slow melodic song and stuff like that. And I really got what captured me about it was the chorus.
Yeah,
it was a really, really gentle chorus. I give myself 100%. Now I'll find myself here forever. I remember just listening to that way back then. And I thought that is brilliant. And obviously, time went on and stuff, and the band kind of went their own separate ways. And there was another band, maybe about 5 years ago, called Resuscitate, again with Daryl and Jev. And a guy called Steve Harrison. and Steve Colley as well. He was on bass as well, and he did a few gigs and stuff like that. And they brought that song back.
Joke?
No, they brought it back.
They played it in the set.
The only thing, they did it a couple of times, and it was at the in the nines.
Didn't know.
I think it was when we had a band. They organised the night. I think Brian Cannon came down and did an art. It did his microdot exhibition, where I spent an absolute fortune. And then Bez came down and did a DJ set with his son, and then they had Mad for It and the Resuscitate playing between.
Awesome.
So yeah, and then that was one of the songs that they played that night, as well as a few of the other ones. They did it acoustically, and believe it or not, Dennis, he was actually in that band, Shy Ted, was, he lived, he emigrated to Australia.
Yeah, I do remember, yeah, he moved, yeah.
And by chance, he'd happened to be back in Barrow that weekend, so they got him up on stage and he played that song on acoustic there.
Joking. Oh, wow. Didn't know that. So, yeah, I mean, Shy Ted's, like I said, I saw him a few times. My band at the time supported them in things like the Waterloo and the Healy's and those sorts of venues. But, yeah, they've got the CD here, Rarely Present, Never Missed. So, yeah, it's got four tracks on there, and the third one's 100%. And, yeah, it's a really great song, so good choice.
Yeah,
really
brilliant song.
Yeah. Moving on, the last one is a band I know very well from back in the day. It's The Origin with There Is Love. Tell me about this one.
There Is Love. Well, if anybody wants to go on, if this song's going to get played now, if anybody wants to go and put the kettle on and cut the grass, that song will still be played when they come back, because it goes on for 8.5 minutes long. But this song was recorded in Kendall College in, I think it was June 2000, so just coming up 23 years ago. It was a four-piece band with two brothers, the Byrne brothers, Paul and John Byrne. The bass player was Dave Fisher, and on drums was Michael Quinn, whose nickname was Small Fry.
Small Fry, yes, yeah. I remember.
Yeah, and again, it was back... it was the first gig Acquiesce ever did. And I think they were supporting The Origin, and they had this, they obviously Acquiesce played and stuff like that with their own songs and a few covers, and then The Origin came on. And I remember Paul and John, they just looked really, really cool back then. I mean, I'm not saying they don't now, but you know what I mean? Back then, they just looked the part, like proper indie and stuff like that. Long hair and stuff, more shades, dressed really smartly. And then they just, as soon as they got into the music and I heard this song, I thought it was just fantastic.
Yeah.
Again, like the energy, the passion of it, and the lyrics as well. I mean, this was 23 years ago, maybe longer, that John actually wrote that song. And if you listen to it lyrically, it's just fantastic.
Yeah.
And it's obviously, like we discussed earlier on, Johnny, off air, it was like, it kind of changed a bit when he went really melodic, like towards like the middle of the song, and then where Paul stopped singing and John came in.
Brilliant, isn't
and
it?
And wrote the... Yeah. Right, I mentioned it the other day, that the lyrics to that bit that John came in and sang, I thought it was just fantastic. Looking through my window, this is what I see, thoughts to make a formula to let forever be. I thought, for somebody that age to write lyrics like, you know what I mean, that good, it was just... And that went kind of went strength to strength and stuff like that. They did that for a few years, and then, obviously, the Paul left the band, and then I think Michael Quinn left the band, Dave Fisher stayed, but John took over lead vocal and guitar, and they got another drummer in called Dan Turner, and then they released two more EPs.
All right, do you have them?
And I've got them as well, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. There's not many EP I don't have, mate.
I need to get those off you.
I need to get those off you as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll have to dig them out as well.
Wow. So yeah, I'll just add to that. I know The Origin because I went to school with John and Paul. I joined it, we started it in my mum's basement on School Street, actually, back in the late 90s, and then I left, and then it got new lineup, and yeah, I mean, when I listened to that song, I totally forgot about it, and I was just like, yeah, this is great, kicks ass, it's brilliant. And that bit at the end where it just changes tempo and starts building up again, it's really good song. So, so next up, Optimus Prime, New Day, Shy Ted's 100%, The Origin There Is Love. Thank you for those descriptions. Paul will be back after you hear these three tunes. Hope you enjoy. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Thoughts to make a formula to live forever. Life is one endless road as time looks back at me. There is dreams behind our eyes, a past honesty and to see.
Superb. Three wonderful tracks from back in the day, bringing back, for me anyways, a lot of memories. Maybe not for the younger, for the younger audience. I hope you enjoyed it if you've heard those three tunes for the first time. For the older ones like myself and Paul, hope you enjoyed them, and maybe you can remember them or not. But yeah, Optimus Prime, New Day, Shite Heads 100%, The Origin, There Is Love. So thank you again to Paul. So, thank you, Paul, for coming in.
Thank you very much, Jonny. It's been it's been a wonderful afternoon.
Yeah, I really appreciate you taking the time to think about those songs.
No problem at all.
Sharing your memories with myself.
No pun intended there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Our Origin had a song called Memories. So, tell me a bit about where you're at the moment. I know, like, you've been talking about mental health and stuff.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of people who know me closely and stuff like that. Over the past kind of month or so, I've been really suffering mentally, and I didn't think it'd ever happen to me, but it has. But I just personally want to thank, well, there's four, I'm not going to mention names and stuff like that, but I just want to thank four individuals, you know who they are, who were there for me when I really, really needed them. So thank you so much for that. If it wasn't for you, who knows, this interview wouldn't have happened, I know that for a fact. So just basically thank everybody who was there for me when I was going through my troubles. I still am going through them. But I've reached out. I'm getting the help that I do need now. So it's a long road ahead, but hopefully it's the right road and I'm on the right path. That's my normal kind of life again, really.
That's the main thing, mate. Wishing you all the best and thank you again.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
So yeah, here at Bags of Love, we're big into, you know, supporting local community, and I was chatting with Paul about this. You know, people give the name a bad reputation, but for different reasons. But from my experience, you know, people rally around, people do support each other, and that's what we're all about with Bags of Love. We've raised now over £6,000 for Barrow Food Bank, helping those in need, and you know, that's one of the best things about living in this area, is that people will support those who do need it. So if you do, don't feel afraid to reach out. That's the main step, really. So thanks again to Paul. Thank you to the two students who have produced this, Matt and Megan. Thank you very much. Thank you to Matt Kassell here at Furness College, as always. I've been Jonny Swift. The next two, well, the final two tracks you'll hear on the podcast is Alba Burke, Sentimental. Alba Burke is a Canadian band with local links, so like we're international now. I put a notice out asking for more tracks, and Alba Burke sent me one of their tracks called Sentimental, which is another really cool, well-produced pop track. And the last song you'll hear is one of my own called Pigsty, which is my latest single. I've got a video up for that at the moment, so feel free to give that a watch on YouTube and a listen on all social media platforms via CS Records. Yeah, thank you for listening. We'll be back again each month, hopefully, with some more local music and interviews and live sessions and other kind of stuff. So thanks again for listening. I've been Jonny Swift, Bags of Love Podcast, June 2023. Thanks for listening. Listen to my heart.
possible.
Bags of love, welcome to